Griff and I just arrived here in Minneapolis. We're at the Sculpture Garden near downtown. We're gonna check out the city and see a couple job sites. Tell us about that.
Yeah, we're gonna meet with John from Prinsco and a couple contractors, and they're gonna show us some commercial stormwater detention systems. Should be cool.
We're excited. Hi, Harris.
Kevin.
Nice to meet you.
Griffin.
Kevin, welcome to Corn, Maine. Let me show you the yard.
Awesome.
We've got a long history of working with contractors and providing them the products that they need. These products are crucial to having a clean, a cost-effective solution. The pipes used to convey stormwater from anything from a parking lot to development, municipal street. When there's a rain event and you see the roads flooded, it has to go through an intake and then be conveyed out to either a stormwater chamber system or to an outlet, you know, to our rivers and streams. If the pipes weren't there, the water would just sit on top of the surface and create problems for municipalities.
So, Jeremiah, tell us a little bit about the project that's going on here.
Well, we're setting these chambers here to catch all the rainwater that's coming off the new apartment building here. As they build all these new buildings that are in here, they add all more hard surfaces. It's going to take on a lot more water. So this actually acts as a storage container for the water until it gets up to a certain elevation, then it slowly filters into the city storm sewer.
What are some benefits to this product compared to other things you could be using?
Plastic's a lot easier to deal with and handle with compared to like corrugated metal pipe where it's got sharp edges and stuff like that on it. We usually don't have a lot of room on these sites.
I mean, you guys look pretty packed in here already.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. These are pretty compact. You got your 6-foot by 4-foot pallet or whatever, and you can just kind of stash them. You can just swing them down in the hole and we can move them to wherever we need them to. Once you get them down there, you know, like they'll set that one pallet there, and then you can just pick them up off there and just start stacking them as you go. Just two guys, they can maneuver them around.
We appreciate you showing us the product.
Absolutely.
And taking your time out of your day.
It's nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you too.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
All right, so we're here this morning in Minneapolis with John Santjer from Prinsco. Tell us a little bit about this project.
Apartment complex is called the Peregrine. I would guess this is probably the fourth or maybe fifth time this site's been redeveloped. So yeah, it's got kind of a rich history to it and a lot of things going on. Real tight site. Contractors been working like crazy. They found some things on site they had to kind of work around. So yeah, it's been a little bit of a challenge out here.
So Jesse, tell us a little bit about the project here.
Well, we're putting in one of your guys' big infiltration systems, which kind of had a hiccup here. Ran into a cistern and an old loo, they called it.
Plan was just to leave it there and to just build around it. The beautiful thing about HDPE pipe and Prinsco having a fabrication shop, you know, located fairly close, is that when things go wrong or they need to make changes to things, they can easily, you know, manufacture a custom T or an elbow, custom stick size to kind of fit the site. And this is it's really shining with this project because they've had to make some adjustments.
Griff and I have seen some stormwater jobs. We've seen chamber job. We haven't seen a perforated pipe going in for stormwater. Tell us, you know, a little bit about how that works exactly.
Yeah, so the system is designed similar to a hydrostore chamber system where it uses a lot of brushed angular stone as backfill, kind of surrounding the pipe. They'll have some geotextile down that you'll see that kind of separates the native soils to the system, so to speak. It's perforated pipe, so, you know, it's catching all the water. And it's allowing for infiltration, you know, to seep back through the ground.
How is Prinsco's product more resilient than competing products like concrete pipe or steel pipe in this instance?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, just the ability to flex and change, ability to fabricate parts, you know, in a matter of a few days. When there's an emergency like this, like we've had out here on site, where they need to change things and really, you know, make some updates quickly, they've shined really, really well.
I wonder what kind of connections we're gonna make throughout just this whole trip that we're going on right now.
Yeah, I think that's a super cool part. The industry is super well connected and they really care for each other and care for their product, and they're super excited about the future of water management. Definitely weather events that we've been thinking about, and that's kind of the, you know, theme of the trip, is how is this gonna affect us? And as both of us are young men, you know, wanting to have a family in the future and wanting to have a, you know, future for them, how can we better sustain our society through water management?